everybody. I am here. And this Friday, we are playing Heart Fragment. Yeah. Begin.
Somewhere in this world, a world filled with tragedy, filled with pain, filled with people whose hearts have fragmented over time as they experience misfortune.
Ooh, voice acting.
Somewhere in this world, a happy ending must await, right? If such an ending doesn't await us at some point along the road, what was the point of traveling it in the first place? But maybe is a happy ending really just an end point in your life? Maybe it's an ongoing journey. Maybe people shouldn't see one ultimate happy ending, but
multiple happy endings along the way.
Or maybe that's stupid. I don't really know. But I believe tragedy can't be the only option. I want to believe that, at least.
Good luck finding it. That happy ending we all hope for.
And it starts. Please be aware horror, very pog.
Say?
Is there something you want to say?
I think I'll go with this.
Is there something you want to say?
Lana, read me a story.
All right. What story did you want to hear this time?
Little Red Riding Hood.
Aw, this looks very wholesome.
Please.
You sure do love Little Red, don't you? Is she your favorite? Doesn't the wolf scare you?
Nuh-uh. I'm scarier than you.
You got me. You're a brave little girl, aren't you? Come up onto my lap. I'll read the book for you.
Yay!
dead, isn't she?
Looks like I kicked off all my covers in my sleep again, too.
Let's just be polite.
Morning. Sorry I'm late.
Yes. Well, good. Yes. You have a good day.
Her face.
Did you want breakfast?
To not disturb her. Ooh. Interesting. He's still wee.
Thank you.
happens. Yes, a smoker. Literally just, yeah.
So they were euthanized, killed off. Their lives ended as humanely as possible, and the experiment marked a failure. The risk was too great to continue any further. But one man, the lead scientist of the project, didn't want to just quit. Still desperate. Last attempt at the drug, hoping to side effects. Then he injected the drug into himself. It was too late, though. The drug was considered dangerous already. And the scientist, despite showing none of the horrific side effects, went into hiding with his wife after realizing that he'd never convince anyone he wouldn't turn violent as well. The man was never found, and with complete silence from him, perhaps proving that he'd kept his sanity, eventually the search was called off. The failed experiment was called to a close and buried.
Transition.
important.
Dad?
Not so loud, you'll wake Ray. My name's Kay. I'm sorry if I frightened you.
You didn't frighten me.
All right, if you say so. Sorry about that. I promise I'm not here to hurt you. I'm here to warn you, actually.
Warn me about what?
You're in danger. Really big danger.
Oh, no.
I promise you, if you tell anyone about the things you learned today, things will go terribly wrong. There's someone after you. His name's Jasper.
After me?
Please be careful. One wrong move and things will go terribly, horribly wrong.
Girl, are you still up?
I have to go now. Take care of yourself, okay? Be back soon. Be careful.
Avoiding me won't help a damn thing.
Yeah, fine.
Listen, about last night, it wasn't my intention to piss you off. Guess I just find it tough to speak to you and all that.
Sure.
Oh my god.
I did. So, here's your chance to explain things in a way that'll make you look good before I find the truth myself.
You wouldn't find a damn thing.
And why not? All I had to do was search your name to find all this.
That news article doesn't even scratch the surface, and not a single other source even tried to find an answer.
Huh?
Sean. Shannon.
So, I have something I gotta tell you.
What's up?
Okay, so, you know Dustin Bladham, right? He asked me out!
You invited me over this weekend. No offense, but you having a new boyfriend isn't exactly big news anymore.
You know, this one is different. I really like Dustin. Plus, we were friends for a long time. I never want to hurt him.
And you said that about Hunter.
Well, if you don't like my taste in boys, you can always just leave. Meanie.
You're such a drama queen.
Or cursed. Yes. This. So many emoticons. Thank you. transition. And quick save. It's him. Chaotic banter. Master Manipulator. Precious Kitty, Mr. Muffin Cakes. Yes. Was a jump scare, but I was not really fazed. it's him. This guy. This guy. Holding onto his tie that is pretty loose. Jump scare. Good court. Transition. is a mutant too, isn't she?
Are you awake? Oh, good. You're up.
I can't help wondering why you keep coming here. You said you want to keep me safe, but can you do that from your little hideout or whatever?
Oh, I'm sure to Gray it seems like there's nothing to worry about. Some people worry too much. Gray doesn't worry enough. He thinks that not telling you about any danger will somehow keep you safe from them. I think you'll be safer if you know about the dangers. Yeah, sure.
Blistered.
Sorry, I can't.
I can turn on the light for a moment if you need.
I'm blind.
What? I'm sorry, what?
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realize.
You literally can't see.
It's alright, really. Besides, it isn't like I'm put at much of a disadvantage. I know this town by heart, better than anyone else. Move around pretty easily as long as I observe with my ears.
Can I ask, well, were you blind from birth?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Right, sorry. So, here's a new topic. How am I different from you? Since I'm not entirely human.
That's a really good question, actually. I know you're supposed to have powers, but Gray never mentioned you doing anything, well, powerful. I asked him about it a few times, but he's never given me a straight answer about what powers you have.
Which part? Being a mutant? Or having a guy climbing in through my window?
Really late? Sorry, I guess you're tired. I didn't mean to bother you. Okay, I'll get going now. See ya.
Tuesday. transition. Let's talk to her.
I guess you could say I only have eyes for you.
Awkward laughter. Mm-hmm. this.
Can I help you?
What is your name? My name is Natalia. I hope you and I can become friends.
I have no idea what you are.
Have a nice day.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
very fucking ominous. his face was flushed.
I saw you earlier on my way out, across the street, staring at me. Why are you watching me?
I'm not.
You very clearly are.
No, you misunderstand.
Plus good.
I swear, this isn't what it looks like. I'm Clive. I just moved into the area, and I've been, exploring. I'm sorry I was watching you, and I'm sorry for knocking you over, too. I was coming around the corner so fast, and I didn't see you. I like to jog, but since I've seen you two times now, can I assume you live around here? I just moved here.
Kind of. I'm moving soon, so you won't see me around too much after tomorrow.
Oh, sorry. My bad.
This is Kay's sibling. Achievement. Suspicious weirdo. Danger, danger. Oh, it's this guy.
Hello, little mutant.
He meows. Oh, meow.
Thank you.
hospital. Him again.
Who are you?
What? You don't remember me?
This guy.
Please. You are.
Maybe I didn't introduce myself properly last time we met. I apologize if I was so rude that I'd missed such an important line. I'm Jasper, but most likely you've heard about me by now, right?
Wait, did you just save me?
Let's see. You just fell. I caught you. Yes, I suppose by definition I'd say I saved you.
More to the point, why did you save me?
You were falling.
I already know that much. Put me down!
No.
He literally just says no. Yes, destiny. Saying that, you weirdo!
When my brother first told me he was going to die that day, I didn't believe him. I thought he'd gone insane. And yet, as he predicted that day, he left me alone. For years, I rationalized it as coincidence. I'm sure you, of all people, know what it's like.
question. Oh, even more ominous. Hand. Okay. Flustered. He behaves like a stray cat. He's heard enough. Yeah. It's her, she's the party. They look like siblings, sorta. Yes, behaving like a stray cat. I know from experience on what stray cats are like. Thank you. shards. Okay, I'm going to end the stream right here. I'll post the schedule either later today or tomorrow.